Okay, I'm starting my broadcast for today. There's a few different things that I'm going to do. I've noticed I've got a few people that are watching today. So if you are online and you'd like to introduce yourself, please feel free in the social stream. On the right-hand side, you can notice there is a chat box that happens over there, and it has an area where you can introduce yourself and say hello. And that is how we will keep track of who's been here and who hasn't, and for you to ask any questions as I go through some of the information that I would like to share today. What I've done in the past two shows is I've gone through the daily Twitter feed that I deal with every single morning. I use a program called Zitte, or Zite, spelled Z-I-T-E. It's an app that I use on my iPad, and what I do with that is I take the information that is given to me in that program, and I read through the different articles, and what it does is it searches the World Wide Web and brings in all the blog entries and all the newspaper articles and any information that has to do with online learning or has to do with areas that I'm interested in, technology, gadgets, education, e-learning are all areas that social media is another one that I deal with. And so when those come in, then I spend some time reading through them to find out what's going on. Now, what I will do is I will just sort of speak to some of those messages and some of those entries, and hopefully share some information that you may find interesting and information that you may not. One of the articles that did come up was an article that said whether or not you should buy an iPad for your child or not. I have found very few tools, and this includes the DS that my son uses. This includes all the other video games that my son has been involved with that is as useful as the iPad. One of the things that I find very interesting when you purchase an iPad for a child is how quickly they take to the iPad and how quickly they figure out how to use it. You don't have to give them a lot of lessons. You don't have to be competent in the use of them at all. What you do have to be aware of is what you actually put on as your apps in the iPad scenario. So when you're purchasing the iPad for your child, take a look at the different apps that are out there, and you'll find there are many great educational apps that your child will find very, very useful, and it will help them in their schooling. So my son is a little challenged when it comes to math. Well, my child's challenged at many things, but one of the ones that he does have a challenge with is math. And I'm sorry, that wasn't fair. My son is actually doing very well in school. His math is probably his weakest subject, because he's decided that he's not very smart in math. So what the iPad does is it allows him to play games and work on his math skills. And as his math skills increase, he will find that it is not as big a challenge as he thought it was, and he'll do quite fine in math. So this article that I'm talking about is called The Case for Buying an iPad for Your Child. So take a look. That will be on my on TADO in a few minutes. One of the other articles that comes up is it talks about the Pinterest, which is the latest social media product that is out there that everyone is flocking to. One person called it the other day, it's the virtual hoarding area. What you can do is, as you surf around the net and you find images that you find interesting, you can actually add them to your Pinterest social networking feed. And what that does is, being an artist, I put some of my artwork on there, and if other people find that my artwork is interesting, they will take it in and they'll pin it to their boards or their bulletin boards, and you can just collect articles and collect information from all over the place. The reason why the person named it the Hoarder's Dream is because it can allow you to put a lot of different stuff from all over the World Wide Web into one area. The nice thing about it is it always gives credit back to where it actually came from, which I find very interesting. Okay, I notice now we have four current viewers online, and I still have no one putting anything in the social stream, so I'm wondering if someone would like to post their name or put some information in there just to see if it actually works. If you are out there and you're watching, feel free to add your name to the list. Or just add your name or ask a question about some of the things I'm talking about. There was a real interesting article that came across that I sat and I actually read through this one piece by piece, because what it the title of it is called Education by Numbers. And what it talks about is some of the percentages that are out there. And so 76 is one of the things they said, that 76 is the percentage of teachers who report that their school budget decreased in the last year, which is kind of interesting because that's a very large percentage of people who are, we're getting less and less money in order to do the job that we are asked to do in the school division. 63 is the percentage of teachers who say that their class size increased in the last year, which is kind of interesting as well. There's lots of research out there that says a smaller class will allow you to do a better job as a teacher. I don't know whether that's true or not, but that is a percentage that's out there. 16.4 million is the number of children in America who are living in poverty, which we always see on the World Wide Web how poorly some of the children are doing in other places around the world, and we tend to forget about our backyard when we're talking about charities and things like that. It's a kind of a shocking number when you talk about 16.4 million people, children, excuse me, are living in poverty. That's kind of a scary percentage or number, excuse me. 64 is the percentage of teachers who report that in the last year the number of students and family needing health and social support services has increased. 28% of teachers say that the health and social services have been reduced or eliminated in their schools. So there's an increase of 64% of students and families that need the health, and then there's 28% say that they've reduced the services that are available. 50 is approximate percent of teachers who leave the profession within the first 5 years. That means one in every two teachers will quit the profession. $77.3 billion is the cost to American school systems each year as a result of teacher turnovers. So these are all discouraging stats, but I don't think any of them, as it says in the article, come as any surprise to anybody who's actually involved in the school system. But again, that was a very interesting article that came across the desk. The next one that I would like to speak to briefly there was an article that talks about rethinking education, and this educational reform is one of the paths and one of the areas that I have been checking into quite frequently in the last couple of years, because I find it very interesting some of the challenges that are happening down in the United States of America, and some of the challenges that we're actually coming across here as we try to restructure our high schools and our school system in order to better fit the needs of the 21st century student, as they're so called, or the digital student. But that information is there. Again, it's a nice read. There's a couple of articles on there. It's a couple of videos, excuse me, that are on that and are worth reading through and checking it out, because it's just a nice list that he's got. Anyways, that's my broadcast day. I've got a message here that says it's working just fine from here on my feed. I'm not too sure who put it up there, but thank you for the message that says, let me just check and see if I can see who actually posted that. Oh, it's Lisa. Lisa Coquette. I'm happy you've logged in and that you were willing to put a message on here just to see that see the video is actually working. So it's nice to see you, and I hope you enjoyed the posting. And that is my TADO show for the day. Come on by tomorrow at same time, same place, and I will again be broadcasting at that time my thoughts for the day. Thanks for tuning in, people.